All Academy. Always with you.
Hello, my dear students. Welcome to this online video lecture on elements of mechanical engineering. So in the previous session, we have discussed about the various energy resources, the advantages and disadvantages of renewable and non-renewable energy resources. And in today's session, we'll going to discuss the very important topic, that is fossil fuels. What are the types of fossil fuels? That is coal, petroleum and natural gas, how they are formed. Then we'll discuss the fossil fuel system, which is known as an energy conversion system or used to convert the fossil fuel into electricity. Then we'll discuss the types of fuel, that is solid fuels, liquid fuels, gaseous fuels, biofuels, and their advantages and disadvantages. And at the last, we're going to discuss the very important questions which may be asked in the university examination on these topics. So without wasting much time, let us begin with today's session. So let us start with a simple definition of fossil fuels. So what are these fossil fuels? The fossil fuels are the energy resources which have the large quantity of hydrocarbons. So these are the energy resources which have large quantity of hydrocarbons. Such a fuels are, we call it as fossil fuels. And these fossil fuels are classified into three types. One is coal, petroleum products, and the natural gas. Now, how these hydrocarbons are formed, that is very important. The hydrocarbons are formed from the ancient living organisms that are buried. So that are buried under the layer of a sediment which have gone a million years ago. Means the whatever the ancient living organisms are there, like in previous, so the 1,000 million years ago, so due to the change in the atmospheric conditions, so these are buried under the earth crust, and due to sedimentation process, so over a long period of time, so these hydrocarbons are formed in the buried living organisms. And how this sediment layer is formed, so based on the heat and the pressure, so due to the continuous, as we all know, due to the heat and change in the atmospheric conditions, so the hydrocarbons start to means the organisms, whichever organisms are buried under these earth crust, so they started to form, or they transfer themselves into hydrocarbons. So this is how the fossil fuels are generated. So let us study in details how the formation of coal takes place, how the formation of petroleum products takes place, how the formation of natural gases takes place individually. Now the first thing is the petroleum formation. How the petrols or petroleum formation takes place or occurs, so that we'll going to see. So these are formed mainly from the ancient microscopic plants and the bacteria that are lived in the oceans and the salt water seas. So here you can see this small figure, how these oil or the petroleum products are extracted. Okay, so whatever the ancient microscopes or plants or bacteria are there, so these are buried under these things. So that will help you to produce the petroleum formation. Now these microorganisms died and settled in the seafloor. Means when they died, they will settle down in the seafloor. So they mixed with a sand slit and to form an organic rich mud. So please note that. So whatever animals or whatever the organisms that die in the sea, so they settle down in the sea floor and they will mix with a sand slit and they form a organic rich mud, and which gradually heated and compressed, chemically transferring into metals. Means as the day changes or as the season changes, there will be raise in the temperature or fall in the temperature, as well as the pressure or atmospheric changes. So these, the chemical transformation takes place, so that will takes into, means the whatever rich organic mud is there, so that chemically transfer into petroleum. Now the liquid petroleum gases, which are less dense than the water, move upwards. Means whatever the liquid petroleum gases are there, liquid petroleum gases which are less dense than the water, means which are having a lesser density compared to the water, they will come upwards through the earth crust. Now it passes through the impermeable layers of a rock, which traps the petroleum, creating the reservoir of petroleum as well as natural gas. Means after these thing, after here in this figure you can see this. So after that, the chemical transformation takes place. When the products which are having less density compared to the water, they will start to move upwards and they will create one reservoir. So which is known as the petroleum reservoirs. So these are the reservoirs where the petroleum and natural gases are extracted. And this is how the petroleum products are extracted. So let us know into the next thing, the formation of coal or the coal formation. So these coals are formed from the ancient plants, including trees, ferns, mosses, that grow in a swamps and bogs along the coastal shorelines. That is very important. And the plants died or were buried under the layers of sediments. Means whatever the plants die on these areas, so they will settle down or they sediment into earth layers. Means they settle down in the earth condition due to sedimentations. So these coal formation takes place. Now increased pressure and heat caused it to undergo the number of transformation state to form a coal. So after a change in the atmospheric conditions, so there will go a different step by step process will be there from the buried organisms to form into a coal. Now they become a carbon rich component. Successive stages of the coal formations are pits, bituminous coal and the anthracite. So these are the stages, and in this figure you can see this how these coals are formed at different stages. So let us look into the next thing, that is a natural gas. Now the natural gas formation, so it is formed by plankton, tiny water dwelling organisms including the algae and protozoan. So that accumulated on the ocean floor as they died. Means as these the organisms including algae and the protozoans die, so they will settle down or they will accumulate at the ocean floor. They will accumulate at the ocean floor and they will start to form these natural gas. They will start to begin the formation of the natural gases. Now as they slowly buried under the compressed under the layer of sedimentation. So in the sedimentation process, so they will first they will buried and they will start to compress, and due to changes the sedimentation process will begins. Now due to the pressure and heat, they are converted into natural gas. It is mainly composed of methane and other light hydrocarbons. So the natural gases forms the layer over the petroleum. Means whatever the, so gas means obviously it will have a less density. So the first, the whatever the after the formation of these the when the liquid the carbon content increases, so the dense liquid will comes first over the lighter dense liquid comes over the water, then the gases will come at the top of a petroleum products. So this is a simple schematic that shows how these are formed, how these are extracted. And even as I said, no, so this is a simple method behind or the principle behind the formation of a natural gas. But to extract methods, if you go on, so there will be different methods to extract these gases. Okay, now how these are natural gases are formed? So they are formed due to the slow buried and compressed under the layer of sedimentation. So what are compressed? So the including algae and protozoa, which are died and accumulated on the ocean floors. So in all the three cases one process is common, that is a sedimentation, the heat and the pressure. In a coal formation, in petroleum formation, as well as in a natural gas formation, so these are three important layers. One is they are buried under the earth, sedimentation process, then the heat and pressure application, then they will start convert chemically, they will start to convert themselves and they will form into particular formations. So hope it is clear now how these coal is formed, how the natural gas is formed and how the petroleum products are. So let us move into the next thing. The next very important is a fossil fuel. Means let us discuss in details about these fossil fuels and how the energy is converted from these fossil fuels. Now the fossil fuel contains the combustible elements. So what are the combustible elements? That is carbon and hydrogen. So these are the very important elements that are required for the combustion process. Now, on combustion, they produce the enormous amount of heat, which can be used to convert some mechanical energy, and that mechanical energy is used to convert into electrical energy by means of using some gas turbine or a steam turbine. So this is a simple process you all know. Whenever the heat is generated, that heat is utilized to convert into mechanical energy, and whatever mechanical energy is this, that is used to convert into electrical energy by means of the steam turbines and the gas turbine. Now the heat energy is also converted to mechanical energy in IC engines for running an automobile. So this is all you know, though. Means whatever the IC engine process takes place, that is completely because of the heat. When the heat is means the in the combustion, the explosion will take place, that produces an enormous amount of heat, and due to that heat, the mechanical energy is utilized to run the automobiles. Okay, now the fossil fuels are used to generate the electricity. So the systems which used to generate electricity are called fossil fuel cells. So fossil fuels is a general term. The fossil fuel cells are the units which are used to generate electricity. So let us discuss this one in details. The whatever sketch block diagram you are observing, this is a fuel cell system which is used to generate an electricity, and this is a block diagram which shows a different process. So here the coal is fed, then the fuel processor, it includes fuel processor, then the membranes, then the anode and cathode, then the air supply, then the direct current operators, then inverter, and here the current will comes out. So let us study how the coal is getting converted, is used to extract whatever energy from coal is that is extracted to generate an electricity or current from this process by using this process. This whole system is known as fossil fuel system. And in examination, sometime they have asked fuel cell with a neat sketch, explain the fuel cell. No need to confuse, you need to draw this figure itself. In some question paper, they have asked with a neat sketch, explain the fossil fuel cell system. So this is the only one diagram for that one. You need to draw this one. So let us know how these energy conversion takes place in the fossil fuel system. Now the coal is converted into hydrogen rich gases in the fuel processor. So whatever coal we take, it so pure coal, so we'll pass it to this fuel processor, where it is the whatever coal we supply, that is converted into the hydrogen rich gas. So here the whatever coal is there, that is in a solid form, that is converted into gaseous form, that is which is having a hydrogen rich gas in a fuel processor. So what is the main work of fuel processor? It converts the coal into hydrogen rich gas. The next is this hydrogen rich gas, the rich hydrogen gas is fed to fuel cell. This complete unit is called as a fuel cell. Whatever you are seeing, so this complete unit is a fuel cell. So this is a complete unit, it is called as a fuel cell. In this fuel cell, so here again oxygen is supplied, as you are seeing. So oxygen is supplied. So in a fuel cell, H2 is passed to the anode on one side and oxygen is passed to the cathode side. So here the anode side, so this is the anode side, and here the hydrogen, rich hydrogen gas is passed, and at this side the oxygen is supplied. You are seeing this oxygen supply, and it is fed to cathode side. Now during this process, the DC current is then converted into AC by means of an inverter. At the cathode, the positively charged ions combines with the oxygen to form a water which flows out of the cell. So due to this, the positively charged ions, they oxygen to form the water which will flow out from the cell. Now the polymer electrolyte membrane between anode and cathode, here you can see this a small block. So this is a membrane, so this is a polymer electrolyte membrane between the anode and cathode, allows only the positive charged ions to pass through the anode and cathode, while the negative charged electrons flow to the cathode, creating the electric current. So that creating of electric current is utilized. This is how the current is, or electricity is generated from the coal. So this is a complete fuel cell system. So hope that this is clear to you people, and in every exam this question will be asked. So with the neat sketch, explain the fuel cell system. So let us discuss the in details about the fuels. What are the types of fuels? What is a fuel? So that we'll going to discuss, and what are the advantages of different types of fuel. Now the fuel is a combustible substances. How I can define the fuel? It is a combustible substances containing a carbon as a main combustible element, which on complete combustion liberates a large quantity of heat, which is called as a fuel. Means what are fuels? These are the combustible elements on combustion, on complete combustion, they'll release the enormous amount of heat or the heat energy. So such a fuels which liberates the heat are called as a fuels. Now how this energy is liberated? That is by the combustion. We all know this. And the how combustion takes place? The fuel, whatever fuel we are using, so then oxidizer has to be used, means we need to supply oxygen for the combustion process. Then the combustion products, after this combustion, when they will burn, so they will form the products, combustible products, and they will form the, or they will they liberates the heat energy. So this is how the fuel generates the heat energy. So one is the fuel requires sufficient oxygen for the combustion. After that combustion, they will eliminate two things. One is a combustible products and another one is a heat energy. So we use this heat energy. So whatever combustible products are there, so these are little bit means they are hardly heavily impacting the environment. So now, because of these major issue, so nowadays the fuels fuels have been alternated by using some of the biofuels. So that we will discuss in the further sessions. Now in general, the fuels are broadly classified into three cases, or based on the phase of the availability, phase, whether they are available in solid or liquid phase, gaseous phase. Based on that, the fuels are broadly classified into three types, as I clearly mentioned. So still there are other types of methods to classify the fuels, but based on the phases, so I have classified. So one is a solid fuel, then the another one is a liquid fuel, and the gaseous fuel. So these are the fuels based on the availability of the phase and what phase they are available. So the fuels are classified into solid fuels, liquid fuels, and the gaseous fuels. So let us discuss what is the solid fuels. The solid material which on complete combustion liberates the amount of heat in order to produce the energy, means so they eliminate or they liberate the heat energy when they are burned, or when they are burnt or the combustion takes place with respect to these solid materials, though these liberates some amount of heat energy, or they can be utilized to produce the energy. Such fuels are called as solid fuels. Now here you can see the solid fuels means, so you can easily, I have shown some pictures, wood, coal, then this is a peat. So this is a peat, and there are again these solid fuels that occurs in nature, means naturally occurring solid fuels such as wood, peat, lignite, and coal. So these are the examples. Similarly, prepared means the prepared solid fuels, means artificial, means the man-made solid fuels are charcoal. Is different, coal is different. So that is a very important, many students will get confused here. Charcoal is different, coal is different. Charcoal, coke, then briquetted coal, then pulverized coal. So pulverized coal means it is in a powdered form, whatever coal is available, so that is made into small minute particles, powder they will make, that is a pulverized coal. So charcoal, you all know what is a charcoal, and coke also you know. So these are the solid fuels. So let us discuss what are the advantages and disadvantages of solid fuels. Now the advantages, if you look into the advantages of any solid fuels, so the solid fuels can be stored easily without any risk of explosion. Yes, obviously, unless and until we make it to burn, so these will not react with the environment, so easily we can store them. Then the solid fuels can easily transported. Yes, obviously they can be easily transported. You can see the woods are transported using trucks, and even you can handle them easily. So you can easily transport them. Then the cost of production is low. The cost of production in the sense, the way of manufacturing these products is lower compared. Means wood, we can grow it in a large, trees can be grown in a large, and wood we can be extracted. So it is the production cost is less. Then the availability is in a large quantity. Obviously, So it is available in a large, woods are available in the large quantity. Coke is the highest extract, the coke, coal, whatever coal we are using, the coal is a maximum, means the in a, used in a large quantity in the entire world. If you compare in the as a fuel, coal is in a product which is used in a large quantity compared to other fuel. So these are available in a large quantity, that's why we are consuming more. And let us look into the disadvantages of in a solid fuels. The first one is the ash content of in a solid fuel is very high, and ash handling is also a major issue. Means when they will burn or when they will combustion takes place, so they will form a ash, they will form a powdered surface after the combustion, and that is very difficult to handle. If you just burn the wood, you can see the ash is formed, so that is difficult to handle. Means in a small capacity it is okay, but when we are using in a larger capacity, it becomes very difficult to handle that quantity of ash. So it is a major issue in the solid fuels. Now the next important is the combustion rate control cannot be easily controlled. Means whatever combustion is there, it cannot be easily controlled. Means I cannot fluctuate based on the requirement. Once it is I have fed some quantity, means so I have to feed it. So I cannot easily control the combustion rate. The next one is the calorific value is lower compared to the liquid fuel. So what is calorific fuel? It is the amount of energy or it is the amount of heat required to raise the 1 degree of a temperature of a unit quantity of a water. Means it is a calorific value can be defined. Means it is the amount of energy required to raise the 1 degree Celsius of a unit mass of a substance. So the calorific value of these solid fuels are less when compared to the liquid fuels. Now they produce a large quantity of dense smoke. Obviously, yes, they produce a large quantity and dense smoke is created when we burn them or when the combustion takes place. So these are the few advantages and disadvantages of in a solid fuels. So let us move into the liquid fuels now. Now what are these liquid fuels? The liquid fuels or complete combustion liberates the liquids, which liberates the on complete combustion, which liberates some quantity of in a heat, which produces the energy, are called as in a liquid fuels. So on combustion, the liquids which produces the energy or liberates the heat are called as in a liquid fuels. These are available in nature in the form of crude petroleum. Crude petroleum, they are available. They are not directly the petrol, we cannot get directly. We won't get the kerosene directly. We won't get the diesel. So these liquid fuels are available in nature in the form of crude petroleum. So after these crude petroleum, whatever the extraction of crude petroleum is takes place, so these crude petroleums are refined, means they are purified, and at different stages, so we'll get the different fuels, liquid fuels, means petrol, diesel, kerosene. So these are extracted or these are purified at different stages, and this process is called as a distillation. Distillation, by using a distillation process, the crude petroleum is distillized, and they form at the different stages, these products are formed. Petrol, diesel, kerosene. Here you can see this one. This is a petrol, diesel, kerosene. So you are more familiar with these liquid fuels as well as solid fuels. So let us look into the advantages and disadvantages of this liquid fuels. And one more very important is the non-petroleum based products. So these are petroleum based, and non-petroleum based liquids are alcohols and biodiesels. So these are the non-petroleum or biofuels, we can say that. These are the non-petroleum based fuels, means these are not extracted from these crude petroleum. So from the crude petroleum, petrol, diesel, kerosene are extracted. And these are the non-petroleum based. Apart from these crude oil, these are extracted separately or these are manufactured separately. So the advantages of a liquid fuels, if you look into this one, is first one is liquid fuels have a higher calorific value. If you have a higher calorific value, means I can get more amount of heat energy. So that is that's why these fuels have a high calorific value. That is why we are using petrol, diesel for our transportation in the process. Means IC engines, we are using them in a large quantity because they produce a huge amount of heat energy. The next one is the combustion of a flame can be easily controlled. Yes, obviously the flame can be easily controlled based on if a fuel supply is there, if I fix the controller or a regulator, based on regulator, I can easily control the supply of a fuel. The next one, the ignition of a liquid is very easy. So liquid, the ignition can be easy, it can easily ignite it. So if the fire, you can see, you have seen some of the videos on social media. So somebody has taken some bottle of petrol or kerosene. He wanted to put some it on a fire. So suddenly it will catches the fire. So these, the ignition of liquid fuels are very much fast. The liquid fuels burn out, forming the ash, dust, kindling, etc. So these, yes, obviously they do not form any ashes, dust. Means in the combustion of just take an example of your vehicles. So the in vehicle liquid fuels are used. So in that one, so we don't get any ash or dust particle. Obviously there will be emission of carbon dioxide after the combustion, but we don't find separate dust or ash in the combustion after burning these liquid fuels. So these are the some few advantages. So now let us look into the some of the disadvantages of liquid fuels. Now the cost of liquid fuels are relatively high. Yes, if you compare the solid fuels and liquid fuels, the liquid fuels carries some high cost because they have to be extracted from the crude oil. Then again, they have to be transported from one place to another place. So these all includes the on these ones. So we need to pay it a little bit higher when we want to use these liquid fuels. Then the storage is a very a special storage design has to be made. I mean, we need to have a prepare containers which should not have any leak, because there is a risk is also there. So a storage tank has to be designed, a well-designed storage tank has to be maintained. Next, the great risk of fire hazard, obviously. So even a small leakage can make you a very dangerous hazard. So it may create a huge accident. So it is a great risk of hazard. The next one is in few liquid fuels, they emit the bad odor. So some of the liquid fuels, they emit a bad odor, so which you may not feel comfortable. So these are the some few disadvantages and advantages of fuels, that is the liquid fuels. So let us look into the gaseous fuels now. Now the gases which on combustion liberates the amount of large quantity of heat that is in order to produce the energy are called as gaseous fuels. The gases which are on combustion, which liberates the heat energy to produce energy are called the gaseous fuels. Now the gaseous fuels occurs in the nature, as I said. So these occurs in the form of natural gas near the petroleum fields under the earth surface. So before the extraction of near the petroleum products, so these natural gases are also extracted. Now the artificial gases that are produced are coal gas, producer gas, water gas, moon gas, blast furnace, coke oven gas, and sewer gases. Apart from this naturally available the gas, that is which is called as natural gas, even we use the coal gas, producer gas, water gas, moon gas. So these are also used as gaseous fuels, and these are the artificial gases, means they are man-made gases. Okay, so this is about the gases, and let us look into the advantages and disadvantages of gaseous fuels. Now the advantages of gaseous fuels are, so the complete combustion is achieved with the minimum air supply, means so if I supply, why the minimum air is required, means so they will easily mix, the gases easily mix with an air, because both are in the same phase, both are in a gaseous phase. So the minimum air is required when compared to other fuels. Next, the combustion can be easily controlled. Yes, as in the liquid fuels, if I have a controller, if I have a regulator for the supply of this gaseous fuel, I can easily control, I can easily violate. The best example is in your household, that is LPG gas. This is which is in a liquid phase, in the LPG gas. So that can be easily controlled. So that can be easily controlled using your regulator. That is why they can be easily controlled. Okay, LPG gas, you can say that. The next one is the ignition of gases is very simple. Yes, if you just ignite it, they will immediately catches the fire. So it is very easy to fire. Easy to ignite. The next is, these gases do not pollute the environment. Yes, when compared to other solid and liquid fuels, these gases do not emit, they did not pollute the environment. That is why the eco cars or eco vehicles, that is the LPG autos or LPG cars, are being insisted to use LPG autos the most in Bangalore city, and in nowadays even in all over the country. So you can find these LPG cities, so LPG gas, LPG autos. So that's why, so the reason behind it is, they emit the less, they less carbons, means they do not pollute the environment. That's why these gases do not pollute the environment. So let us look into the disadvantages of gaseous fuels. Expensive compared to the solid and liquid fuels. Obviously, they are expensive to the liquids and solid fuels. The best example, your LPG. So even though after getting subsidy, we are getting the LPG for 15 kgs, we are paying around 800 plus. Even it is having subsidies. So think on it. So how it will be if without subsidies are there. So these are quite expensive when compared to solid and liquid fuels. The great risk of fire hazard. Yes. So we have seen many incidents due to the gas leakage, due to the gas leakage. There are many incidents have taken place in across the world. In India also, so we have seen a very biggest disaster, one of the disaster which is known as very dangerous gases incidents we have seen in India also. Recently in Hyderabad, the gas leakage has made many people in Hyderabad, in Andhra, I think. So it has, due to that leakage of gas, many people have died. So there is a leakage chance is more, so that the hazard is also having a high risk. Now the transportation of gaseous fuels is very difficult. This is a very important. The gases transportation is a little bit difficult for one place to another place. So if any things goes wrong, suddenly it will takes. Even we have seen such incidents in Karnataka also, in some of, I don't know which place exactly, in the nearby the one village, some gas container have been lorry, means the truck, the transportation unit has been met with an accident. Suddenly the gas leakage, due to that leakage, surrounding around 20 to 30 people have died in Karnataka. So the transportation of these gaseous fuels are also very dangerous. So that's why this is also one of the major drawback of this gaseous fuels. Then the large storage is required. Large storage tanks are required, and these storage tank has to be well designed. So these are the few disadvantages of the gaseous fuels. So let us look into the last very important topic in today's session, that is biofuels. So what are these biofuels? The biofuels are the liquid fuels which are derived from the biomass, biowaste, seeds. And the biofuels are produced from the sugar crops, starch crops, then the oil seeds crops like soybean, sunflower, rape seeds, and animal fats. So these biofuels are the alternative fuels. So which the recent days the researchers and experiments are going on these biofuels. Because the first major thing is, due to the, as we continuously using these whatever available resource, the conventional fuels like petrol, diesel and kerosene, what we are using, so on one fine day they may exhaust. Definitely they will going to exhaust from the from us. So to avoid that condition, to avoid that in future, the alternative fuels have been developed. So these are called nothing but the biofuels. And these biofuels have same, means they, even though the same characteristics, maximum they will act like a normal conventional fuels. They will have a same characteristic like calorific value, methane content, ethane content. So they have something, some almost carbon content. All the things are almost related to the conventional fuels. That is why the researchers are going on this one. And even some researchers are using these biofuels in IC engines. And even they have experimented it, they have came successfully with a good results. So biofuels in future, they will going to play an important role in the growth of any country to control the atmosphere, to control the greenhouse gases, to avoid the hazard, to avoid the damage to the atmosphere. So these biofuels plays a very important role. Now these are the some of the products which uses used for the production of biofuels. Now let us look into the advantages of biofuels. Why we need to use? First one is the efficient fuel. The biofuel is made from the renewable resources and relatively less flammable compared to the fossil fuels. Means when I use these, whatever after conversion of extracting the oil from these fuels, even these products can be used. Means the extracted the whatever sugar cane, after extracting the energy, these fuels from these contain, I can use them, and these are renewable resources. They do not harm the environment. Then the cost benefit. Obviously, yes, the cost benefit, because when I start producing these one, the agricultural it will also support the agricultural area. So then again, all the things will be economically balanced. So it benefit, the cost is benefited, and when compared to the our conventional fuels, so these fuels are little bit in price, they are lesser. So that's why it is a cost benefit. Next, easy to source. Source means I can easily extract and I can easily grow. And you can see that India is the second largest country in the world to grow the sugar canes. And that's why we can think on these things. Means we can easily source them, easily we can produce them. And reduces the greenhouse gases. That is why we are going into this alternate or biofuels. Biofuels, that name itself indicates, which helps the biosphere, which helps the surrounding. So that is why the biofuels are being used. So they reduces the greenhouse gases, means they do not emit the carbon dioxide. So when the combustion takes place, they do not emit the carbon and hydrocarbons. So that's why these reduces the greenhouse gases. The reduces the dependent on the foreign oil. Foreign oil means in India, so we don't have that much quantity of enough crude oil supply. Means we don't have crude oil ores. So we have to import the crude oil from the foreign countries like Arab Gulf countries, and even some of the American, even we have to extract from import from the America also. So the foreign dependency will reduces if we concentrate or if you develop the technology towards the biofuel. So this is also reduces if you go through, if you use a biofuels as a fuels. So these are the few advantages and advantages of biofuels. Now let us look into the what are the previous questions asked in the university examination. The first thing is write a note on fossil fuels. So you need to write what is the definition of fossil fuel, how the fossil fuels are formed, and again in fossil fuels, coal, carbon, coal, then the formation of coal, then the formation of petroleum products, and the formation of natural gas. So you need to explain in some simple words, and this question is asked for 6 marks. Then with a neat sketch, explain the fuel cell. So here you need to explain the fuel cell system, whatever I have shown you, that diagram you have to draw it, and you need to write the procedure of conversion of coal to electricity. So that procedure you need to have. So this question will be asked for 8 marks. And the next is list out the advantages and disadvantages of solid fuels, which we have already discussed. And minimum we have to write 5 points advantages, 5 points disadvantages. Minimum we have to write it. Next, what are the liquid fuels? You need to write the definition, then advantages and disadvantages of liquid fuels. So minimum, as I said, minimum 5 points advantages, 5 disadvantages, and the definition of liquid fuels. So that is for 8 marks. Then what are the biofuels? The definition of biofuels, list the advantages and disadvantages of biofuels. So you need to write it. So these are some important questions on these topics. So hope, dear students, so whatever concept we have discussed in today's session, hope it is clear to you people. And still, if you are not able to understand any of the topic, you can comment it in a comment box and we'll try to clarify your doubts. And in the further session, we'll going to discuss the very important topics like wind energy, solar energy, nuclear energy, tidal energy, hydel energy. These all topics we'll going to cover in the further session.
Click on subscribe button and press the bell icon to get updates from All Academy.